this is Connie Belden, and we're going to talk about the accounting equation and how transactions make accounts go up or down. First of all, I want to take a look at our Chapter 1 notes and just look at this section on the accounting equation, which is assets equals liabilities plus stockholders' equity. Asset examples are listed here. Assets are cash or other items that we own that have value. Note that accounts receivable is money that somebody owes us. Liabilities are the opposite. That is money that we owe others. Accounts payable is usually shorter term, 20 to 45 days. Notes payable is longer term, such as a car loan. Mortgage payable is even longer, such as a loan on a building. And wages payable is generally the wages that we owe our employees who have worked, but we have not paid them yet. Also note that notes payable and mortgage payable generally were charged interest, referred to as interest expense. Now, stockholders' equity is divided into two parts: common stock and revenues, which cause stockholders' equity to go up, and dividends and expenses, which cause stockholders' equity to go down. Common stock is when somebody invests in our company, generally they give us cash or another asset, then we give them shares of stock. As the company does well and earns money, we then distribute to them dividends. That's basically distributing part of our income to stockholders as kind of a thank you for investing in my company, also to continue to invest in my company. Revenues, such as fees earned and sales, are what we generate from doing business. And expenses, such as rent expense, utilities expense, are expenses that we have to pay that come about from doing business. Now, let's take a look at the book examples. And again, the accounting equation is assets equals liabilities plus equity, or owner's equity. And keep in mind that stockholders' equity is the ownership or the right of stockholders in a corporation. They have invested money or other assets in our company in exchange for shares of stock. So they are now our owners. Let's take a look at transactions and see how they affect the accounting equation. First of all, when a business transaction occurs, it's going to affect at least two different accounts. Now, when it affects two different accounts, the accounting equation still has to balance. So let's take a look at this first transaction. Chris Clark deposited $25,000 in a bank account in the name of Net Solutions in exchange for he sold shares of stock. So in other words, he sold stock in his company. In exchange, those investors gave him $25,000 in cash. So now the company has an increase in assets or cash of $25,000, but also an increase in common stock, which is under stockholders' equity, of $25,000. And that's fine that both of these went up because they're on opposite sides of the equation. So in this case, both cash or assets and common stock or stockholders' equity went up. If they're on opposite sides of the equation, they can both go up or they can both go down. Now, in transaction B, Net Solutions paid $20,000 for the purchase of land, and they paid that in cash. Cash and land are both assets, so they would be affecting the same side of the equation. So when two assets are involved, one asset is going to have to go up, and one asset is going to have to go down because they're on the same side of the equation, and they have to balance out. So in this case, land went up, cash went down, but the assets still equal $25,000. We just moved $20,000 out of cash and into land. It doesn't affect anything else. Stockholders' equity is still $25,000. Transaction C. We purchased $1,350 of supplies and agreed to pay in the near future. That would be accounts payable because we're not paying it right now. So therefore, assets of supplies goes up and accounts payable goes up. So both sides of the equation, because assets goes up and liabilities goes up. Now, accounts payable goes up when you buy something on account. Think of it as a credit card. When you buy something on account, your balance goes up. When you make a payment, that's when accounts payable would go down. So now both sides are $26,350. Net Solutions received $7,500 in cash for services to customers. So therefore, assets, cash goes up. The stockholders' equity is also going up. Remember we said revenue or fees earned would cause stockholders' equity to go up. So both sides of the equation go up by $7,500. Transaction E. We paid wages expense of $2,125, rent expense of $800, utilities expense of $450, and miscellaneous expense of $275. These are all expenses. We're going to assume we pay them with cash. So each expense causes owner's equity to go down. We do list them individually. You can add them together, though, since we paid them in cash, and cash goes down by $36.50. So assets go down by $36.50, and these expenses together cause owner's equity to go down by $36.50. But again, we listed each one individually. Transaction F, we pay creditors on account $950. In other words, we're paying off part of the balance we owe in accounts payable. Remember, we charged those supplies for $1,350. We're now going to pay off $950 of them with cash. So accounts payable goes down and cash goes down. Also note, when you subtract, your accounts payable balance is now $400. Transaction G, a little bit tricky. When you buy supplies for $1,350 in this case, they are an asset. This would be like pens, paper, pencil. But as you use them up, they need to be moved to supplies expense. So in this case, Clark determined the cost of supplies on hand, in other words, supplies they have left at the end of the month was $550. So if they bought $1,350 and they have $550 left, that means if you subtract, $800 of supplies was used. So therefore, I take $800 away from supplies, leaving me a balance of $550, the amount that's left in the supply storeroom on hand. And then I turn it into a supplies expense. So I subtract it out of stockholders' equity. So assets go down by $800 and stockholders' equity goes down by $800. Transaction H. You had a good year. You made a great net income. So you will pay part of that in cash to your stockholders as a dividend. So therefore, cash goes down and stockholders' equity goes down because dividends will cause stockholders' equity to go down. There are examples of typical transactions that you will see in a business and how it causes it to go up or down. So an overall summary chart would look like this, and you're doing something similar in your homework, where you just analyze each transaction and balance it after each transaction. Then at the very end, you will show your three assets equal $26,450 and that your liability and all your stockholder equity items also equal $26,450. So that's how you can check to see if you balance out. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this video.